Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video session series, I am going to explain you the B-tree. In this session, I am going to cover the introduction given to B-tree. What is B-tree? What are the prerequisites required for B-tree? And how it is different from the binary tree? What are different properties of a B-tree? All these concepts I am going to cover in this video session. Now let's start with different types of trees. All of you are knowing the tree data structure. Tree data structure is a non-linear data structure. These are different types where the first type is a binary tree, where every node is having either 0, 1 or maximum 2 number of children is called as binary tree. The details about binary tree and the types of tree, if you want to know the details, you can go through my previous video for which I am providing you a shortcut link in this write up corner. Now let's go forward for a next type of tree. It's nothing but a binary search tree. This binary search tree is having specific property. What is that property? That you will come to know if you will go through my previous video. These are different types of binary search tree which are self-balanced trees. They are AVL tree and red and black tree. For both AVL tree and red and black tree, for all these trees, its introduction, its different operations that we can perform on all these trees, all these things already covered in my previous sessions. For that you can go through that previous sessions for which I am providing your shortcut link over here. Now let's come on the topic, current topic, which I am going to cover in this video session is nothing but a B-tree. B-tree is not a binary tree. The B-tree is somehow different concept. So what is that B-tree? That we'll see in the next slide. So let's start. Before moving to B-tree directly, let's compare B-tree with a binary tree. So the question in your mind must be, is B-tree and binary tree are same? So here I am providing you the comparison between B-tree and a binary tree. So here I will explain you the B-tree and here I will explain you the binary tree. So the first concept, first topic, that in a B-tree, it must have all of its child nodes on the same level is the first constraint, first information about a B-tree. Now all of you are knowing that a binary tree. So now let's think about whether this is the constraint is as it is equally available with a binary tree. If you are knowing the binary tree, then you will say that it is not having such a constraint. That is, binary tree is not having such a constraint like all the child nodes must be at the same level. This could not be present, or this constraint is not available in a binary tree. So in a binary tree, that may be a skewed binary tree, that may be a complete binary tree, that may be a full binary tree. And there are n number of varieties available for a binary tree where there is no any constraint like all the child nodes must be at the same level. But when you are going to deal with B tree, then you have to think about very first thing that every time all the child nodes are at same level. Now let's go for the next property, next concept with respect to binary tree that I am going to cover in the comparison. That every time this B tree is having m number of subtrees. Other way around, we can say that every node can be have m number of keys with that node. That m is called as order of the tree. Now you must have question in your mind that how it is possible that m number of subtrees, how it is possible m order, how it is possible, or what is the order of the B tree. That I am going to cover all the details in subsequent slides. But in the comparison with this concept, now let's think about what is there in a binary tree. So you must know the concept of binary tree, where every time in a binary tree maximum two subtrees are available for every parent node, correct? As a binary tree is having name itself binary, that maximum two children can be available with every node. So here m number of subtrees are available, here only two subtrees are available. That m number of subtrees are represented by m order. Here order is 2, always maximum 2, because the name is binary tree itself. So I think this is the primary information about a binary tree. I am trying to explain you the binary tree in comparison with I am explaining a B tree in comparison with a binary tree. Means, as all of you are knowing, what is binary tree? Binary tree is very much famous and self-explanatory. With the concept of binary tree, you must know what is B tree. That's why I am explaining all these things in comparison. Now let's move forward for a B tree. Now let's deal with a B tree only. What is B tree and what are different concepts related to B tree? So now let's start. So now we will start with a B tree. So this is nothing but one special type of search tree. Okay, this one is the search tree, not only a general tree, but this tree, it can be used for the searching purpose. So the name is given to this tree is a B tree. Now, as I explained previously, that a node can store more than one value, which is nothing but key, because this is the search tree. That node value, we can say that one is key. So this node can have more than one value. This is the special property of this B tree. And that's why it can have more than two children. So how are we going to utilize this property? That I am going to explain in the next slide. Before that, we'll go through the description or the fact about B tree. B tree is a self-balanced search tree with multiple keys. As I explained previously, every node is having the multiple key and more than two children for every node. Up to two children we are having a binary tree, but if the requirement is like to store more than two children, for that we will be having the B tree. Now the details about B tree I am going to explain you. Like, the B tree is a self-balancing search tree. It is self-balancing. At the time of insertion or deletion, the different properties that we need to follow, by applying that property, it is get self-balanced. So that's why this tree is called as self-balancing search tree. Now, in comparison with the another search trees like AVL tree or a red and black tree, mainly these trees where the whatever keys are stored in that different trees are available in a main memory itself. Now if the things are available in main memory, it means that there are less number of values can be available, or these tree are dealing with the less number of values. But when the number of keys are high, at that time the data is read from the disk, which is the secondary memory, in the form of blocks. So now when these number of keys are going to be high, that is, if I want to read data from the disk, in that case what happens? The disk access time is very high in comparison with memory access time. So if huge data is available that I can't store in the main memory, that I have to store into the disk to access that values or keys, in that time if I want to access it from disk, it will take very high time to access that value. So what is the solution for that? So the solution is B tree. So the main idea of using B tree is to reduce the number of disk accesses. So this B tree is or can store the huge data in itself. So instead of storing it into the main memory, because for the less values AVL tree, read and black trees are available, so where that the data can be available in the main memory. But if the huge data is there that we can't store into the main memory, that we have to store into the disk. But if I'm going to store that value into the disk, it will take very high time to access that data. So instead of that, the solution is to use B tree. So it reduces the number of disk accesses, or it reduces the time required which is used to access the disk. So that's why I will use the B tree. Now what the more things about B tree, that now all of you are knowing that the huge data is not fit or cannot fit into the main memory. That's why we are going to use the B tree. So if I am going to store different values, huge data in the form of B tree, then the operations that we are going to perform onto the tree, it will take the OH, disk access time. The time complexity will be big OH, where H will be the height of your tree. Now let's go forward. Now as the huge data is going to be stored in a B tree, that tree is called as fat tree. Why this tree is called as fat tree, I am going to explain it with the help of example. Now let's move forward. Time being, I'll explain that all these things. Now let's move forward, that the height of B tree is kept very low, and as the height is low, this tree is going to become a fat tree. How that height is going to become or is kept as low? By putting maximum possible keys in a B tree node. That is, the number of values, keys that I am going to store into the node is going to be increased. Maximum possible number of keys I am going to store, and it forms that my tree is having the low height, and as the height is low, the tree is going to become fat. Now let's move forward, that usually or generally B tree node size is kept equal to the disk block size. That is, what the number of keys are going to store in a disk will be the size of your node. And now the thing with respect to B tree is that height is very low, correct? As I explained previously, height is very low. That's why the total disk access for most of the operations are reduced significantly. Because if height is low and my leaf node is present at the deep position, then the disk access time is very low. And that's why this is nothing but the tree where searching is done very fastly in comparison with the disk access. So now let's move forward for the next concept with respect to B tree, is the order of B tree. As I explained previously, that every node can store more than one value. In a binary tree, a single value can be stored, but B tree is a special kind of tree where it stores the more than one value, more than one key. So the number of keys in a node and the number of children for a node is depend on the order of the tree. Other way around, we can say that the number of keys which are present in a node which decides the order of the binary tree. So every B tree is having an order, that may be order 2, order 3, order 4, order n, and so on. This is the example, like if a node is there which is having a single key value, so it will be having a first child and second child. So if a one key value is there, maximum two children are available for that every node. This is called as the order of the tree, where For this given example, order is 2. This is the order 2B3. So here you can see that the two children are available if a single key is there. If one key is there, two number of children are available, and the key will decide the number of children, and that number of children will decide the order. That's why this is the tree of order 2. Now let's see one more example for the order. That if order 3, I want to represent a B tree with order 3, how it will look like? So it will look like this. This is the node having two keys. Am I right? This is the node having two keys. Two keys are there. It means 2 plus 1 number of child nodes are available. So this is the first child that will be representing in this way. This is the second child which will be at the middle of these two keys, and this one is the right, the third child which is present in this way next to the second key. So if two keys are there, 2 plus 1, that is 3 number of children are available. That's why the order of this tree is 3. So I repeat, order of a B tree is depend on the number of keys present in every node. Maximum 2 number of keys can store in this example of tree. That's why the 3 number of children can be available, and that's why this tree is having order 3. Now let's move forward for the properties of B tree. This is one example I am going to explain you. Here you can see that this is the B tree of order 4. With respect to this example, I am going to explain you all the n number of properties for this B tree. Here you can see that this is the B tree where every node is having more than one key value. Is the first thing that you need to always keep in mind with respect to B tree. Now let's move forward for the first property. Property 1 is all the leaf nodes must be at the same level. You can see that these are the leaf nodes which are available at the same level. Now let's move forward the next property. Property number 2. Already all these things I have explained in the previous slide, that all non-leaf nodes except root must have at least m by 2 minus 1 number of keys and m by 2 number of children. M is nothing but the order. In the opposite round, I have explained that if the number of keys are there, that is will decide the order of the tree. Now let's consider we are having an order. Now let's see. This is the tree with order 4, where 4 divided by 2 is 2 minus 1 is nothing but the 1. So at least this is the statement which showing you the minimum number of keys available and minimum number of children can be there. So 4 by 2 is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. So minimum single key must be available, and if a single key is available, 4 by 2, that is 2, 4 divided by 2, result is 2. So minimum 2 children can be available. So as I explained previously, if a single key is there, 2 children must be there. This is the property who is showing the minimum constraint. Now let's move forward the maximum constraint. Third property, for again all non-leaf node except root node, it must have maximum m minus 1 keys. If the order is m, that is m number of children are there. I have explained in the next half part of the statement. If m number of children are there, m minus 1 number of keys must be there. Maximum. Okay, so this is nothing but the minimum constraint. This one is the maximum constraint. Now after that, the next property is with respect to root node. Both the properties were explaining the non-leaf nodes, they are except root node, so they all are intermediate nodes. Now let's think about a root node. If the root node is a non-leaf node, if the root node is a non-leaf node, means subtrees are available, in that case it must have at least two children, because a single value must be there, single key must be there in a root, and if a single key, minimum single key is there, it will be having at least two children. So this property is with respect to root node. After that, all the key values within a node must be in ascending order. This is the very important thing that you need to always keep in mind. Here you can see that any of the node, key values within a node. Here this is the node where the both the values are present in the ascending order. You can see any of the node, that is here the node is nothing but 15, 21, 23. You can see any of the node, like let's see, this is the node 71, 73, 75. All the values, keys which are present in every node are in the ascending order. It should have get follow this property by every node. And the last property is time complexity. Time complexity to perform all these operations like search, insert and delete is nothing but just same as of your binary search tree, that is big O log N. So in this way, these are different properties that you need to always keep in mind while constructing the B tree. Now let's move forward for the types of search tree that are I'm going to explain you in the comparison with respect to different parameters. Like here I'm going to explain you these are the things with respect to a binary search tree and these are the things with respect to the B tree. So this is nothing but the conclusion part, where till this slide, whatever I have explained in the previous few minutes, that I am going to summarize in this single slide, that the number of values or the keys present in every node are nothing but in binary search tree, they are single always, but here in B tree they can be more than one. The number of child nodes 0 or 1 or maximum 2, but in the case of more than 2, because at least one key must be there in a root position, so minimum 2 children must be there, but that can be more than 2. What are special kinds? They are in a binary search tree they can be the AVL tree or a red and black tree, but in a B tree they are M ordered B tree. Accessing data from the main memory, as the less memory is there, less memory, less values are there, but here huge data we can store, that's why that can be accessed from the disk storage in the form of blocks. Not huge, that's why main memory, huge, that's why from the disk storage. Time complexity is big O log N, where N is the number of nodes. Here if with respect to height we are going to find out the time complexity is big O H, but with respect to number of nodes, again it is just same as of the binary search tree, that is big O log N. The appearance, it is height balanced, it is having low height, that's why it is called as the fat tree. And the node size, as I explained previously, a single key value is there, it is equal to the disk block size having the N number of keys. So thank you dear friends, I hope you are getting the concepts of B tree. Please stay tuned with my channel, please do not forget to give the comment. Here I am providing you the subscription link as well. If you like the content and the video, please like my video, please subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Please do share it with your friends. Keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification. Here I am providing you the subscription link. Please subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Here I am providing you the shortcut link for the next few videos in this series. Please stay tuned. Thank you.